is the gaming and welcome to the Dawn of Man. Now this game has been out since the 1st of March this year. I bought it back in June, but I haven't actually played it because at the time of wanting to record this, I was actually playing Airport CEO. But now we can finally begin playing this game. But before we do, if you could be so kind as to like this video, share it with your friends, and subscribe if you want to see more, that would be amazing. And if you could be so kind as to help me reach 50 subscribers, that would be awesome. Now, without further ado, we're going to get into it. Okay, so, new game. You have not completed the tutorial. Unless you really know what you are doing, we highly recommend that you do so. Do you want to play the tutorial now? Yes. Okay, so you get to go through, gather berries and fruits during summer and save longer lasting resources such as cured meat, dry fish and grain for winter. Right, so during summer you gather berries and fruit, and during winter you eat things like meat and grain and fish and all that. So that seems simple enough. Okay. Press any key. Okay. In the game, you control a band of ancient humans striving for survival. This tutorial explains basics. You can check the in-game help for more advanced directions. Okay. Dawn of Man uses FPS-style camera controls. Move the camera using WASD keys. Rotate the camera using Q and E keys. Okay, zoom the camera using the mouse wheel. Okay, so standard controls. Okay, that's a bit weird, but okay. Q. Yeah, good. Note, you can pivot the camera around a point by rotating and panning at the same time. Right. You can check out the more advanced controls in the help section and customize the keys in the settings menu. Okay, so we're gonna do this. Your people will need a constant supply of food to stay alive. One of the more predictable resources of food is fish from rivers and lakes. To send people to fish, select a river, then click on the fish button. Okay. So in general, you can assign tasks to your people by selecting objects like trees, rivers, animal structures, then choosing one of the options in the selection panel. Okay. Next, you should be gathering some basic construction and crafting materials like sticks and flint. How do I... Okay, so I how... Build. Plant. Manage game speed. Okay, so wait for your people to get one unit of raw fish sticks and flint. Use button or press 4 to set game speed to 8. You now know how to assign tasks to your people. This is a good way of micromanaging them. Okay, so we're gonna speed 4, which should be fine. Okay, place a fish Z to make it smaller, C to make it bigger. We're gonna have, okay, that's gonna take a bit of getting used to. Okay, place a gather sticks work area. Oh, quite a big area here. Okay, place a obtain flint work area. Obtain flint. What I might do is set an area here. Collect and harvest wild plants. That bird was way too close. Allow free workers in the gather sticks work area. Gather sticks. In the... Okay. Wait for your people to... Well done. Your people will now continuously gather resources until the limit is reached. Note that berries can only be gathered in summer. Other resources in the game can only be gathered in a particular season. Okay. Now that you have some raw resources, let's craft some hunting tools. Okay, so production is crafter. Wait for your press 4. Oh, got a few animal. Whoa, that is a. What are these? Cows, by the looks of it. Yeah, some form of cows. Okay, that camera movement is going to. To craft tools, select the crafter, then click on tool recipe. Okay, right click is not actually working. Mind you, production is going up very fast. Okay, so flint. grain processing. We now have all the tools we need to go hunting. Okay. Hunting was a tricky business in the Stone Age. Killing a large animal with sticks and stones was no easy feat. Use primal vision to find easy prey, highlighted in green. Avoid large animals and carnivores until you have the right tools and manpower. To hunt an animal, select it, then click on the hunting button. Tab. Okay. Green. Is there anything? That had to be the quickest I've seen someone kill. Once the animal has been hunted, your people will butcher it and bring the resources to camp. When hunting in this manner, your people will decide how many of them to send based on the difficulty of the prey. Okay, so if there was only one person, it couldn't have been that hard. Sometimes you might want more control over your people's actions. You can do this by selecting a few people, then right-click on the terrain or target. This way you can move around or assign one or more individuals in a particular task. Right. That was, yep, okay. You can see an eagle up here. What was that? It's a pig, I think. Send two people to hunt the same animal. Select them, then right click on the animal. Okay. Okay. F1. Okay. Tab is primal vision. Tab. tab is not working. Okay, so you a boy, adult male. Okay, you. Old man, you can't go. Okay, now that's cool. One of the resources you obtain from animals are raw skins. They are used to craft clothing and build structures, among other things. However, raw skins cannot be used directly. You have to dry them first. In order to do this, you need to build skin dryers. Okay, so how do I build skin dryers? Okay. Let's... adult woman. A few horses that just go through the water like nothing. Always keep a stock of dry skins as they are fundamental building and crafting material in the early eras. Okay. In the game, you earn knowledge points when doing certain actions, hunting new animals, crafting new resources, reaching certain population levels, etc. You can then use them to research new techs, unlock new structures, plants, or mechanics. Okay. The food drying tech unlocks the food dryer, which allows you to process raw meat and raw fish into cured meat and dry fish. These last for a lot longer and can be stored for the winter. These last for and can be stored for winter in a safe place. Okay. Open text panel using F7. Hold. F7. Okay. Open text panel using menu button. Menu button or pressing F7 and research the food drying tech. So F7. Okay. Wait for people to produce 1 unit of cured meat and dry fish. I'll be right. Okay, I've just realized that there's possibly no audio to this. So I'll be right back. Okay, well, I fixed audio. I've had to switch it back to something. I'll have to fix that for future videos. Remember to always dry your food and keep it dry. Keep it in a storage structure to preserve it for as long as possible, okay? Manually producing every item is tedious and inefficient. You can right click on a recipe to toggle continuous production. Your people will then keep on producing the item until the resource limit is reached. Okay, so... your people now continue to produce the tools until the resource limit is reached. Note, some recipes are set to continue to produce by default. Okay, that's good. If everyone is well fed and taken care of, your settlement will reach a high level of welfare and prestige, and more people will want to join it. So this is similar to Stonehearth in a way. A tent or a stone tent. Okay, so we can't no. So I need two tents. Surviving the winter. So is it winter? New humans will now join your settlement. Note that your settlement can also grow when your people reproduce. This plays a more important role when you reach larger populations, as you can have a larger number of births. Okay. You now have You now know the basics on how to run a settlement. Note that there are quite a few other mechanics in the game that are not explained here. You can get more info from the loading screen, hints, UI tooltips, or the in-game help menu that explains all the concepts in the game with a lot more detail. Okay. So that's it. Okay, well, we're gonna end it there, guys, so I hope you enjoyed this video. This has basically been a tutorial video of the game. Next video, we will be doing an actual first looks into the game and how it works, an actual playthrough. So, until then, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, don't forget to like this button. This video, and if you want to see more, subscribe. If you're new to the channel, share it with your friends, family, anyone that you know. Help support the channel, help me reach 50 subscribers. That would be amazing. I'm Jezza Gaming. This has been Dawn of Man. Until the next time, I'll see you in the next video. Have a good one.